Hey everyone, today I have an exciting tutorial for you all. We will be exploring the ATtiny85 USB development board called Digispark. So let's dive right in. First things first, there is a built-in USB connector. That means you can directly program the ATtiny85 using Arduino IDE. It has 8 kilobytes of flash memory, SRAM and EEPROM of 512 bytes each, 6 digital pins and 4 analog pins. Due to the onboard 5V regulator, it supports input voltage between 7 to 35 volts. There is also a built-in LED connected to digital pin 1. As you can see, I am soldering the header pins onto the board. These pins will allow us to easily connect external components. If you prefer boards like Uno, then solder female header pins. I like the mini or nano approach, so I am soldering male header pins. Using Digispark on a breadboard is tricky, since it's not breadboard friendly. So my approach is this. 6 digital pins will be on the breadboard and I will use the jumper wires for the power pins. You can also connect it directly to your laptop while it's still on the breadboard. Not clean, but I'm happy with it. Now that our board is ready, let's see how to program it using Arduino 2.0. First, make sure you have the latest version of the Arduino IDE installed on your system. Once you have that set up, follow these steps. Go to File, Preferences, and paste this link inside the Additional Boards Manager URL section. You can find this link under the description of this video. Next, go to the Boards Manager and search for Digistump. Digistump is the company that manufactures Digispark. Install the Digistump AVR board package. And with that, let's upload this simple blink sketch to the board. Please note that the built-in LED is connected to pin 1 internally. First, go to the Tools section, then Boards, Digistump AVR Boards, and select the default board. Don't connect the board to your laptop yet. First, click on the Upload button and wait for this message. Plug-in device now, timeout in 60 seconds. Now insert the Digispark into the USB port. If everything works fine, you will see a successful upload message. In my case, the LED is blinking perfectly. Finally, let's put our ATtiny85 board to use by utilizing its analog and PWM functions. We will control the brightness of an LED using a potentiometer. And this is the program for the same. After uploading it to the board, connect the LED to pin 1 through a 220 ohm resistor and the potentiometer to pin 2. Connect its end terminals to 5V and ground respectively. Once you power the board, you will be able to adjust the LED brightness by rotating the potentiometer, just like I'm doing here. And that's it. You are ready to create more cool projects with this board. Thank you for watching. If you like the video, consider subscribing for more such tutorials.